So good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss on the topic of culture and seed production of lettuce calcarifer, that is CBAS. Already we have discussed about the common traits of few cultivable finfish with respect to the brackish water aquaculture. So without delaying, we are just going to the slides. So, as all of you are knowing that Asian sea bass, the name is lettuce calcarifer. So, in this slide, you might have seen this image. This is Dr. S. Iyappan, who was earlier DG, Director General of ICR. So he was just inaugurating the center of Asian sea bass culture in Siba. So we are just going ahead with the subject. So the Asian sea bass, as all of you are knowing, that the classification, they belongs to the phylum Chordata, class Actinopterygii, then order Perciformis, family Letidae. Somewhere you might have checked Centropomidae as well. So Centropomidae, the family Centropomidae, was the earlier classification, but the recent classification is the Letidae. Okay, then genus is Lettuce and species is Lettuce calcarifer. So Asian sea bass, it is also called as giant perch. Earlier it was classified into the family of Centropomidae, and in India it is called as Bhetki or Baramundi. So this is highly eurihaline habitat, and they inhabit in highly eurihaline habitat, as well as they enable the culture can be taken in the fresh water as well as in seawater condition, and because they live in estuaries. So distribution is, the distribution of this species found in littoral water of Indo-West Pacific region that extends from Iran to Australia, and it is very profitable culture as they attain a much more larger size within a short period of time. And so it is profitable culture carried out in most of the Southeast Asian countries, especially in Thailand and Taiwan. It was the Thailand in 1971 when the first induced breeding was successfully done. Then with continuity, what is the major problems during Bhetki culture? It is found that they are very predominant cannibalistic during young stages, generally 1 to 20 gram. Then after this, they also depends on high protein rate. As they are carnivorous, they are dependent on high protein palatable feed, and as well as they dependent on the trash fishes, which is staple diet of poor in developing countries. So these are the problems. And the third problem, that is the unpredictable wild fry availability. So if you will go to the natural collection, we are unpredicted about the upcoming of southwest monsoon, as upcoming of southwest monsoon, the fry comes into the backwaters where the wild fry or the species has been caught for the culture, for the grow out. Then in India, fry availability abundant in east coast than west coast. Then the fry availability is more in east coast when compared with the west coast. So what is importance? Importance is that in shrimp farmers, it is the most lucrative finfish culture after the shrimp farming, because of their demand, then the price they fetch. Third, they attain larger size within a very short period of time, 8 to 12 months. That is 8 to 12 months. So generally, how these ancient Sivas culture cycle carried on. So Sivas, where the larval stages is supposed to be in general of about 30 days. So these hatchery produced fry, they are graded. After the grading, they are kept in pond, cage or cement tanks in nursery stage, where the nursing of these fry is carried out for 1 to 2 months. After that, again, they are graded for the grow out culture, where the culture of these fingerling is done for next 5 to 12 months in pond, pen or cage culture. Then here you can see that how this grading can be done. The grading is done when wild caught fry, you can directly go for the nursery culture, or directly after if you have caught, means in three stages you can start the vetky culture: from induced breeding, from taking the artificial insemination, from the stocking of the fry or fingerling stage up to the grow out. So either you can start from the breeding, or you just simply collect those fry for the stocking into the nursery tanks or for in the grow out tanks. So prior to that, you must have to grading out that what kind of size of fish that you must have to be stocked for the fry and fingerling. Then how nursery rearing of vetky fry is done. So prior to that, I would like to share one slide with you that how these lattice calcarifer artificial insemination breeding is going to be carried out. So with this schematic diagram, we can understand. I'm just sharing a screen with all of you, so please you can draw it as well. Otherwise I will share these PDF to all of you. So you just see, this is the training manual biology and culture of sea bass that is published by FAO. So how we can do? So either you can do this vetky culture with the catching of these wild stocks or wild spawners, or directly go for the pond and cages reared stocks. So if you are taking the wild stocks, it must be conditioned prior to breeding or hatchery, or prior to initiation of hatchery operation. So wild stocks must be conditioned for the period of 6 months. क्योंकि आप क्या करते हो, या तो आप किसी जो लेटेस्ट कैलकरीफर है आपने वाइल्ड कैच किया तो आप ब्रीडिंग के लिए जाओगे, तो आइदर यू कैन डू ब्रीडिंग दोज फिशेस विच यू हैव एंड दैट मस्ट बी 2 to 3 years ओल्ड, जो आपके केजेज में है, जो 5 to 6 years, तो दे आर ऑलरेडी एक्लिमेटाइज टू द आर्टिफिशियल कंडीशन. बट इफ यू आर गोइंग विद द वाइल्ड स्टॉक, it must be acclimatized prior to breeding and hatchery operation. So these wild stocks, these are conditioned, and the conditioning period is generally 5 to 6 months, so that they can adapt it to the artificial condition. Okay, then after the condition, these brood stock is developed, then the selection of spawners is done, where the spawners are kept in a particular tanks. After the selection of spawners, the hormone manipulation can be done, or environmental manipulation must be there, so that proper breeding can be carried out, isn't it? So that after the spawning, when the eggs are released. So these eggs are incubated further, okay, and after incubation the hatching operation, and they are segregated into different tanks like larval rearing. After larval rearing they are fed on the diet of algae and rotifers, and the larva can be stocked in the open water or in nursery or for the marketing purpose, like those which are mostly involved with the seed sellers, the hatchery owners, isn't it? So they market it. So once nursery pond, they further these species can be segregated into, they can grow into pen or cage culture which have those facilities, or pond culture, and later on they are harvested after 12 months after getting a size of 1 or 1.5 kg, isn't it? So this was the wild stock that you have done through done all this process from the conditioning. But if the wild spawners are there, wild spawners, that is already, if wild spawners are there, then what you do? You simply strip it. Wild spawners that are acclimatized, जो पहले से ही acclimatized है हमारे पास, we simply go for the stripping. These again we incubate the eggs, then these eggs after hatching, the larval rearing and the stocking into different water bodies like in open waters or nursery, and then again after the gradation of it can be done into pond, pen or other cultures. Okay, next, that one is pond and cages related stocks. What you do? Simply these stocks can be developed into brood stock and can be sold to those which are involved with the breeding and hatchery operation, isn't it? तो कुछ farmers होते हैं जो grow out का काम करते हैं, कुछ जो nursery के लिए involved रहते हैं. So a farmer can be involved within these process either of three. ठीक है, इनमें से कोई भी एक वो स्टार्ट करके और वहां पे उनको कैसे कंट्रोल कर सकते हैं वो हम लोगों ने अभी जस्ट डिस्कस किया. देन वी अगेन वी विल गो टू द आवर स्लाइड्स. प्रोबेबली यू माइट हैव अंडरस्टैंड सो हाउ वी कैन इनिशिएट और वी कैन इन्वॉल्व आवर एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप विद द Bhetki culture and operation. Then nursery rearing of Bhetki fry. So generally these are being carried out in earthen ponds or concrete tanks or cages. Then for this the earthen pond size ranges up to 500 to 2000 meter square area, that is length and width. Then water depth that is necessary for the nursery rearing of fry is 50 to 80 centimeter, and 1 mm screen mesh fitted to inlet and outlet gates to protect fry. Generally these Bhetki culture is done in along with the coastal aqua farm or the coastal belt. So there must be the inlet or outlet. It means when high tide flows, so there must be provision of mesh regulation into your inlet and outlet as well, so that fish cannot get out of the water or escape out of the water. Then the concrete nursery tank, the size of this nursery tank must have 300 meter square generally, which is used to culture of these fry with muddy bottom and water column of 1 meter depth, then aeration by bubbling air through a blower. Because the fry are very susceptible, they accept live feed. ये जो lattice calcarifer का हम जब भी culture करते हैं तो उनके लिए live feed supplementation देना बहुत जरूरी है, because they do not accept any feed that is went down or settled down in the bottom, because they are column feeder. First, second, So what happens? Floating and stationary net cages with 1 mm mesh size, then nursery size ranges up to 3 to 10 meter cube. Those fry which having the stocking density of at least 3 to 10 meter cube, and it should be easily installed and maintained in rivers, coastal areas, or in large ponds, or in calm water areas, free from pollution and menace of biofuelers, because the seeds are very susceptible to those biofuelers and these pollution menace. Then you can see the sea bass nursery pond within your mobile screen, so that you can get a kind of image that how the these nursery ponds is being prepared and the culture is carried out. So you just see these are the nursery tanks, nursery cages where they have installed the bamboo frames as well as the polyethylene seats, and they have stocked the fry. They generally used to stock these fry into these smaller cages, and after the grow, after when the fry becomes fingerling, they simply take these fingerlings out of it and they put into the other side, means the remaining side of these cages is open pond where they used to stock these fingerlings for the grow out purpose. Then you just see Betki nursery in indoor tanks, India. Nursery rearing in indoor cement tanks, what generally used or what is recommended by the these SIBA into this to the Indian continent is they generally suggest that there must be four cemented tanks which should have a size of 10 into 6 into 5 with 700 liter capacity of seawater. The stocking density must have been done 10,000 fry with 100% survival rate, then feeding 4% of body weight and 4 times per day. Generally, if we see the culture of Betki in Thailand, they do twice. They do 100% twice within a day. But in our continent, what they have suggested that it should have the 4% of body weight and 4 times per day. Initial average weight Betki fry is the FCR. The initial average weight what is been observed is 2.5 gram after 45 days, and after 45 days these 2.5 gram of fry attained the size of 91.03 gram, and when the FCR was calculated, it is found that the FCR is 1.15 and PER is 1.07. the temperature is 29.2 to 29.8. the pH is 7.2 to 7.4. these are the optimum water qualities required for the required for the culture of Betki. Then salinity is 31.2 ppt. So 31.2 to 32.6, or generally you can say 30 to 33 ppt. Then dissolved oxygen 5 ppm, 5.5 to 6 ppm. Then ammonia is, it must be lesser than 0.02 to 0.03 milligram per liter. Nitrite should be lesser than 0.01 to 0.02 milligram per liter. As in continuity with the Betki culture in the nursery tank pond in Thailand, nursery pond reared size from 1 to 2.5 centimeter of fingerling that grow up to 5 to 10 centimeter, and all they do prior to 2 or 3 weeks stocking, and where they used to keep feeding production unit separately, and in that feeding production unit they generally culture the Artemia nopilae. These Artemia nopilae inoculated into pond, and that is done at the rate of 0.1 gram per meter square. After when these Artemia nopilae grow to adult size, within 2 weeks they used to feed these Artemia to फ्राई भेटकी और फ्राई लेटस कैलकरीफर. देन दीज भेटकी फ्राई स्टॉक्ड एट द रेट ऑफ 20 to 50 meters square एंड दैट इज द बेस्ट अल्टरनेटिव फीड टू फ्राई दैट इज फाइनली चॉप्ड और ग्राउंड ट्रैश फिश. एंड generally they used to feed at the rate of 100% of fish biomass, fish body weight. After that they reduce it to twice per day in first week and gradually reduce to 60% in second and 40% in third week consecutively. Then about the water exchange is done at the rate of 30% per day. That prevent deterioration of water bodies happened due to the application of feed, fertilizer or any organic matter that is getting accumulated due to the fish excreta or fish metabolic product accumulation. So then in Thailand, nursery rearing in cages fry stock at the rate of 80 to 100 numbers per meter cube. And in nursery rearing of fry, they used to do in concrete tanks. And they fill these concrete tanks with seawater. And early fry stays of 0.5 to 1.3 centimeter, around 1.5 centimeter. And they reared up to 5 to 6 centimeter of fingerling until and unless they grow the size of finger. Then fry stocked at the rate of 250 to 300 per meter square or per meter cube, where the zooplankton of productive shrimp pond of 4 hectare area, that is enough for these estimated 1 million bhetki fry. And at 5 to 6 centimeters sole to grow out pond operator. So now we will proceed with the rearing system of the bhetki, where the bhetki is grown out up to the marketable size. So grow out culture phase varies from 3 to 4 months, that attains 300 to 400 grams within a period of 8 to 12 months, that attains a size of 700 to 1200 grams. Generally, the size of grow out ponds ranges from 0.1 to several hectare. It depends on the area, the stocking density and the input or capability of a farmer. Then in Taiwan, what they do? In Taiwan, the pond concrete walls with soft substrate bottom, where the water column of 2 meter in culture period is kept, where 1 horsepower of engine is used for aeration purpose, where aeration purpose for the 8 paddle wheel aerators. And in this, 5% of water is exchanged. Then in grow out cages, these cages are floating or stationary in nature. They having the shape of square or rectangular. And it may be 20 to 100 meter cube of size. The mesh size of the cage is ranges from 2 to 8 centimeter based on fish size. That we have to consider prior to selection of a mesh size of a net. So you can see the stationary cages, the pencil case of stationary cages for Asian sea bass culture that was carried in 1986. Although in 1971, the first induced breeding of the culture practices was carried out, but it was in the cage system, stationary cages for Asian sea bass culture, bhetki. It was started by Kang Wangki et al. In 1986. Bhetki grow out in ponds. So how these bhetki are grown out into the grow out ponds. So it is more than 80 years in Southeast Asia and Australia that they carried out in mono or polyculture system. Monoculture of bhetki in ponds, what we do,
Generally, prior to stocking ponds, it is prepared by sun drying, applying quick lime, and the organic matter, where the quick lime is applied at the rate of 800 to 2000 kg per hectare. Organic matter is applied at the rate of 300 to 400 kilogram per hectare. Rice bran is applied generally at the rate of 300 to 350 kg per hectare. Then dilute night soil is also used to increase the pond productivity at the rate of 50 tons per hectare. And then the pond is filled with the brackish water, which having the salinity range of 5 to 10 ppt and with a depth of 2 meter. The sethi disc visibility of water should be 30 cm as we keep in other aquaculture production. Then fingerlings of 5 to 6 cm is stocked at the rate of 10,000 to 40,000 per hectare. Depends on the basic input of the farm. Like it depends on the extensive, semi-intensive, intensive or super intensive that we can, these stocking density can be varied. Then these fishes are fed with pre-stress fish like tilapia that should be lesser than 200 gram of size at the rate of 10% biomass in grow out pond. So these stress fishes are fed, these stress fishes are fed to lattice calcarifer at the rate of 10% of body weight. Then they yield 10 million metric ton per hectare. And the average marketable size that is attained is 600 gram within 4 to 5 months and 6 to 7 months in winter in Taiwan due to the change in temperature, with 80% survival has been observed if they are fed with a healthy diet. The water quality parameters is kept optimum level, then the survivability of these fingerling can be taken up to 80%. Then next we will come that how we can do best. So that was the Betke monoculture system. So when we discuss about the Betke polyculture in ponds, so Betke can be cultured well with the introduction of tilapia, because tilapia can resist the salinity range up to 12 to 13 ppt because they are much more resistant. They are very hardy species. So this is the best choice. They can breed multiple times within 1 year, so called prolific breeder. Then and the market price of these tilapia, market demand of tilapia is also there. They are called the aquatic chicken. But prior to do this, we must have to look that what is the main component of this polyculture. So the main component of this polyculture is Betke. Then secondary is tilapia, because tilapia is introduced here as a secondary production or secondary production unit. They are used to feed as a trash fish to lattice calcarifer. So Betke with tilapia is best choice as primary crop in polyculture, common in Thailand and in other Southeast Asian countries, where the tilapia brood stock is kept at the rate of 5,000 to 10,000 per hectare, introduced at the ratio of 1:3 male-female ratio, which breed after 1 or 2 months because they are prolific breeder. Then Betke juveniles is 5 to 10 centimeter that is kept at the rate of 3000 to 5000 numbers per hectare. So why the number of tilapia brood stock is higher? Because tilapia are used as a feed component, as a trash fish. So why the number is kept is higher than that of Betke. And Betke, they are cannibalistic in nature in their initial phase of life. Then Bhetki culture in cages, well developed in Thailand, Malaysia, Indonesia, Hong Kong and Singapore, where the fingerlings are stocked at the rate of 40 to 50 numbers per meter cube. So what is the stocking size of Bhetki and with the different mesh sizes of cages, it is enlisted here. So the stocking size of Bhetki of 1 to 2 centimeter requires a mesh size of 0.5. For 5 to 10 centimeter, it requires the 1 centimeter of mesh size. For stocking 20 to 30 centimeter of Bhetki, the mesh size must have a 2 centimeter of diameter. Then more than, if the Bhetki size is more than 25 centimeter, then the mesh size of cage we can keep at 4 centimeter. So in continuity with this, we know that we should know that fingerling must be stocked when it is attained the size of 50 to 200 gram of weight. After that, they are transferred next cages and reduced to 10 to 50 numbers of piece per meter cube. Okay, so fingerlings are stocked when they attain 50 to 200 gram size. The size is grading is done and sizes are reduced to 10 to 20 feet per meter cube. Then feeding in cages is done twice a day. And what is the feed? These are the chopped fishes at the rate of 10% of body weight. Then for first 2 to 3 months of stocking. Then after 2 to 3 months, the feed can be done at the rate of 5% of body weight once per day. Okay. So you can see there are a few pictures where the sea bass harvest is done in ponds. So in conclusion, the sea bass is a very lucrative fish after the culture of shrimp because they can attain larger size within a short period of time. They are very much demandable in the market by the consumer because of consumer preference. They fetch a good price. So why these Bhetki, these Asian sea bass are more lucrative fish farming in the region of coastal belt, especially in the region of East Coast region, where they used to do these Bhetki culture in bheris. Bheris are the fish farming system or fish farming technique in with paddy cultivation in Odisha as well as in West Bengal. So these are the parts where Bhetki culture can be done in backwaters of the British water, and the farmers can get a good price. So we can think after the shrimp farming, we can go this Bhetki farming. We can go for this Bhetki farming because of their consumer preference and their price. So now the session is open for discussion. If you have any question, you can ask. Otherwise, we will end this session. Thank you.